So maybe, do you think Sebastian knew that it was a bad idea to let him get near it?
Yeah.
I want to ask him, okay, you tricky little shit, what did you learn that would be most useful to us, and what do I need to trade you to get it?
That's a really vague question.
That's why I asked it. I'm trying to lawyer him.
Lawyer him.
You can, he's like, well, useful to you personally, useful to the group, useful to humanity, useful because it's not beneficial to someone else.
So he outlawed me.
I need a little bit bigger parameters. The rule was, the contract was, is that I would tell you anything and everything about what's inside that book in exchange for reading all of it. But
anything that seems like the missing pages that we still need?
Unfortunately, I'd have to see them. Except for I know all and every single one of the books and pages has been sent to JFK Station. By the way, what's JFK Station?
Metro Station?
It's a place, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, it's a metro station.
Just f-ing kidding.
Just for kidding?
Just freaking kidding.
Okay. Aha. Sure, well...
It's a sick joke.
Something there, or whoever there, almost every item that gets transferred out of Arlington goes there. And I know all the pages got transferred there.
So we asked him about the sword, the mask, and the books. Was there anything else we wanted to ask him about? Didn't you guys want to ask him something about the Inquisitor last week?
That might have been Andrew. I wanted to ask Andrew about the diary, but he's not here. I guess at some point I'd like to be able to grab the diary from Andrew, like in passing or whatever, and like sit down and read it, I guess.
Okay. Well, you won't get to do that this session.
Yeah. Wait, where did he wander off to again?
Somewhere. He just said that he was going to go and study the effigy.
What if he tries to talk to the Earl King and sell us out?
I don't know.
I would like to glare at him.
At me or at...
At you.
Well, I don't know the dude yet. He's a creepy motherfucker.
Oh, yes. Yes, he is. Don't worry. He wouldn't do anything that stupid.
Right now, the only loyalty that Roland has to any of you is Ren. I mean, I would cut your head off, but, you know, I don't know who you are yet. I still need an excuse to abandon Abigail and join up with the group.
I'm the cream filling of this big group Oreo.
Yeah, and now you're holding everything together. Yeah.
I guess that's all the questions I can think of off the top of my head. I mean...
Yeah, I thought we'd learn more.
I guess learn a little bit more about the Earl King, like, what's his... I guess we kind of asked all of that last week, didn't we? Like, he's one of the three big guys, and we're looking for his daughters.
We didn't find out Robert knew the Earl King, or what their connection was.
He worked for the Earl King.
Did he?
Yeah, and then he was punished by the Earl King or something, wasn't he?
He tried stealing information from him.
Oh, okay.
Oh, is that what it was?
And that's how he ended up in the skull and why he's not a demon anymore?
Yes.
Okay.
That's what he divulged, is that he tried to steal information.
Why did you say that we could take his word at what he says? Why would we trust the demon?
You say that to Robert?
Yeah.
Well, it's part of the price they pay. To get power, you have to be able to give power. Lying is absolutely a great power.
What the fuck does that mean? So he can't lie?
He cannot. He physically is incapable of it.
And Ren,
that's a lie, because he lied to us like the first day we met him.
No,
he's talking about the Earl King.
He's talking about the Earl King.
Oh, I thought you were talking about like demons and like him in general. Okay, never mind.
So
I was like, what the fuck?
Robert, demons that have hit his rank or higher cannot actually physically lie anymore. Like, they can mislead, but they can't lie.
Depends on who they are, but he's a unique cookie. So he's only part demon, and so to reach that point of like the level that he has succeeded at, that was one of the things that he had to lose.
Is he like a 40k chaos champion? Like, he was a human and he ascended to his level?
What are the other parts?
Robert's like, yeah. What?
he's red.
That's not right, what he's saying. So Robert goes, well, actually, he's not from any of our regular concepts of dimension. Astral or demonic or earthly. He's something else completely. He kind of came onto the scene, per se.
All right, well, I'm going to ask them what they want to do. Do we want to go to JFK and learn more about everything? Do we want to try and find the daughters? Because, I mean, assuming we're pretty much done at the station, Abigail can go fuck herself.
I'm thinking if I go there, I'm going to get fucked, so...
Good point, yeah.
Or North Station, I guess, for sure.
What have you really done at this point that would cause you trouble, other than just bitch at Abigail?
I don't remember, like, the things that I've done that... that got me in trouble, but it's mostly okay. To do with Abigail. Excuse me. Because at this point, I mean, to be honest, we're kind of corroborating, if that's the right word, with demons. So,
well,
to
I mean,
someone like Abigail, that's pretty big no-no.
But she was there when we made the deal, and she didn't, like, outright say that any of us were going to get...
She's like, I'm going to write it in my report. And then, like, fought with
her. If somebody says they're going to write it in their report, I think maybe, like a demotion or some trouble, but not, like, an execution. Like, if she really had a problem with it. I don't know. I mean, we could go to Chinatown and try and start fighting at Janita's people. Find the daughters.
Did you want to steal the report?
Well, I mean, unless you kill her, she's going to get the information back to them somehow.
Yeah.
And I can guarantee Roland's not going to be cool with that plan.
Hey, Versi, what else was it that I did that, like, I would get in trouble at North Station? I can't remember.
At North Station?
Yeah.
You wouldn't get in trouble for much.
Something about, like Abigail's report, and then it was, like, something else that I did, or... It might have just been, like, fighting with her over Biscuit.
Yeah, you were... causing a lot of problems with her, and she said that at a certain point you straight up like said that you weren't gonna do what she said.
Okay.
And she said that she would get you court-martialed.
That sounds about right.
Okay. That's probably what it was then. I thought it was something else, like, but I can't remember. I kind of super wish that I got more power from the Earl King now. Like, that would have been hilarious.
And you would have no longer been a Templar.
Yep.
So right now we've learned what we could from Robert. We need to decide if we want to go after the Earl King's daughters, head to JFK and learn about Xandalfon, talk to Abigail about something, or look into these books. But with them, we have to go to JFK to look about the pages, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. It seems like all the magical stuff is pointing towards JFK.
So it's basically JFK or Chinatown.
But we don't know if those pages are even related to the books, is the kind of the problem.
Well, I mean, yeah, true.
I think going to...
Robert...
For me, Chinatown is more of a, like, I'm gonna go there because I'm trying to find clues about my family.
Robert perks up and he goes, well, how many pages do you think there are that have angelic writing on them? He's like, if you want, I could take a look at the books for you.
I don't like that idea.
No, I don't either.
Suit yourself. I know how to read it.
I want to ask them how they came into possession of this demonic little shit.
Huh?
Why do they have a demon with them?
Why do you guys have a demon with you?
I was not there.
He's a glimpse into the other side, I guess. Like, he has information that no one else would have.
Well, I don't like the idea of working with the enemy, but I guess this isn't the time to talk about it, so...
Oh, just give him a hug.
Right now, I can tell you that if you get court-martialed, Roland is probably not going to be a character witness for you. But let's go wherever we go.
So what's the plan? Where are you headed?
My vote is Chinatown. Because the sooner we get Earl King and the other demon lady off our backs, the better, I think.
I believe Zeke would vote the same way.
Yeah, I'm always down to kill demons.
Okay, so you're headed to, like, JFK and Chinatown area?
Well, how close are they together?
Where's my handout?
South Station.
Can you just ping it?
Chinatown's like down here. I don't know where the JFK station is, though.
South Station, which is right here. It would be...
Ooh, kind of roboted for me there, sorry.
It'd be probably another 6 squares south of that.
All the way down here.
That's where JFK station, like down here, like way down the...
Oh, I can't ping on the non-map.
More like down that way.
Yeah.
But yeah, it looks like we'd have to go through Chinatown to get there anyway, so if we wanted to, we could just kind of loop through.
How are we supposed to find the daughters anyway? I can't remember if he said. Okay, Skype is being weird for people. Alright.
I hear people just fine. Is he...
It's lagging. It's lagging a little bit. The video's lagging. Yeah.
Steven, just leave and come back, I guess.
Guardian down.
Yep. Okay. So we'll give it a second for Steven to get back.
So how's your guys' weekend so far?
It's good. What's a weekend?
It's nice. Well, my cameras are broken now.
Wah, 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 wah. What's that?
That would be something.
I put my screen cover on, huh? So...
Okay.
Hey, did that fix it?
Is he back?
Oh, okay, cool. That's the weirdest thing. Alright.
Skype was kind of freezing
up. Did
it
stop working for everybody
or just for me? Just you.
Okay, well, sorry to interrupt. Let's go back to where we're going.
Okay, so... You were gonna stop by Chinatown on the way to JFK, is what I'm guessing?
Sure.
Works okay. For me.
Oh! Can I ask Robert about the Earl King's daughters, I guess? Like...
Yeah?
Does he know anything about them and stuff like that?
Sure, what do you need to know?
What do they look like? Do they just look all gangly like the Earl King, or?
I think
they were absolutely gorgeous, at least by Earth human people standards. Very, very human in nature. Nothing like most of us look. However, there are some pretty fine-looking demons, if I do say myself.
Would you be able to identify them if we found one?
Yeah, if I saw them the same way if didn't he say something about corrupted?
Yeah, the Earl King straight up told us that that thing that attacked me outside of the station was one of his daughters, so they've been physically and, like, spiritually corrupted. As much as a demon can be corrupted, I guess.
That is Ichinita's style. If she got a hold of them, they're gonna be very different looking.
Yeah, they got fucked up mouths and finger dicks and stuff.
What?
What? Those long, weird fingers.
Yeah. Well, I was gonna ask if he would be able to, like, identify them. And does he know a way for us to un-uglify them? Yeah. Un-uglify them.
I thought we were going with the Biscuits approach.
Just kill them when we can?
We show up, we attempt to save them.
Right. I'm asking, how do we save them?
Yeah, we need to at least put up a convincing show that we tried, or the Earl King's gonna turn on us.
Well,
I didn't say that. I didn't say that out loud. I didn't say that out loud to him. Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. Is everyone else saying this out loud, or are you guys not doing this in character?
I was assuming that whole conversation
was in character.
No, I'm gonna go with
no, because I was trying to make sure that Kiro was aware of what happened last time.
Gotcha. Okay, so what's the plan? How are you guys planning on doing this? Now that you've addressed that situation.
What? So, I was asking him, how would we save them from Itchy...
Okay, so you were asking him...
Yeah, I was asking, but character. The like whole conversation was not in character.
Okay. He goes, well... You all are the biblical heroes. I'm sure you'll figure it out.
I'm gonna just
thanks, Robert.
Glare at Robert. I'm like, you're not very knowledgeable in many ways, are you?
When you have something I want, tell me again.
No. The deal. Oh, no. That's not about the catalog. Never mind.
Not about the book.
Yeah.
Quick, somebody find him a menu.
here's a gum wrapper.
Giant banker box full of Chinese restaurant menus.
Yep. So.
All right. Well, I'll stuff them back in my bag, and we will head out, I guess.
Okay. Cool.
Do I need to explain to Abigail why I'm leaving, or can we just hand wave that?
So last session,
let her know that we're leaving.
Last session, she kind of said that you guys are free to do what you need to do.
Well, they are, but I'm still supposed to be with her, right?
She looped you into it.
Oh, okay, cool. Then fuck her. Let's go.
Wow.
I tried. It didn't work.
Side note. Yeah.
You didn't roofie her, right?
What are you doing with the tool supplies that you guys got?
Oh, I forgot about those. Can we just assign some people from Arlington to bring them to JFK?
Sure.
Well, they go like to North Station, not JFK.
Or ask Abigail to do it for you, if you want to ask her.
Yeah, regardless, the dangerous part's done, right? We got them from the contested area.
Sure. Do you want to talk to Abigail real quick and ask her to do all that?
Sure.
Or if she has people to spare to do that.
Yeah.
If she has people to spare.
Right.
She can find five people.
If not, we can always head north and head back south again.
Okay. So you go and you see Abigail in her office, and she's like, so did you find what you needed down in the vault?
Not
really.
Whatever
information it was?
We searched long and hard, and we didn't really find a whole lot.
Yeah, it's pretty difficult to find anything in there.
How'd you find those pistols?
Oh, huh? Good question.
How'd you find those pistols?
I don't know. Just drawn to them.
All right.
... Okay.
Yeah, I feel like there's more to that story, but...
Enlighten us, please.
Not much to tell. I was down there with the quartermaster before the breach happened, and someone came running down the stairs and we were cataloging and he was showing me around since I've never actually been in there. And when we gained information that there had been a breach, I was running back down these rows of items all cataloged with the tags and whatnot. And right there was a pair of pistols. So I quickly grabbed them and stuffed the tag in my pocket so that we could pull the catalog for it later. And I came upstairs.
Okay.
All right. So we're gonna go do something. Can you spare some people to send the supplies that North Station needs back to North Station?
Yeah, I could probably do that. It might be a day or two, but no problem.
It's already been a while.
It would take us like a day or two to get up there anyway, so.
That's fine. Yeah, I'm sure I could finagle that. Where are you guys headed if you're not going there?
We got something to check out in Ren.
I'm going to Chinatown.
Chinatown.
And she knows my history, right?
Lightly. She's like, what?
She knows I'm from there, so.
She kind of like gives you like a inquisitive kind of like steepled fingers looking at you kind of thing, like going after Ichinita's daughters, huh?
I'm
gonna say, like, I'm more looking for my parents, to be honest.
And I'll say I'm keeping an eye on the kid. Because Ren's young, right?
Yeah. I'm like 26, I think.
Oh, so nice. All right. Well, I'm keeping an eye on Ren then, because kid doesn't make sense.
Okay.
Well, I am younger than you, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, but not really kid. You know, 26 is old enough that I wouldn't treat you like a kid, you know?
I would still call people kid. Like,
kid,
you're such a youngin'.
Well, I'm gonna keep an eye on the little girl then.
He says while looking up.
The little lady.
Yeah.
Keep an eye on the little lady. Well,
the only person I've met in the last 2 years is taller than me.
Yeah. She's like, all right. Well, I won't stop you. Good luck with that.
You're not going to flip her off as you leave the room or anything, Ren?
No, she didn't do anything to me specifically that's, like, pissing me off, so.
I'd like to...
Good luck with Arlington. We'll try and stop by later.
Gonna roll a performance check, Zeke, and sing Fuck You as we leave the room?
No, I was actually saying, I'd like to roll
Why? Why are you trying to passively get us to do it when you could just do it yourself?
I have no problem with that.
Sir?
Roland respects her. But I've seen nothing but animosity towards her. Yeah. Also, I like the idea of him just saxophoning Fuck You as he walks out the room.
So what are you going to do, Zach?
I'll just go with his idea. I'd like to roll a performance check for... God, what's... Careless Whisper.
Okay.
Oh, it did, there it is. Woo!
Hey, good plan.
Okay, cool.
So we all just kind of back out of the room as he plays.
so he...
I'm gonna grab him by the
explain how
the
you leave the room while playing
and, like,
a saxophone
of
Careless Whisper. Okay, so you, like, Ren's kind of, like, dragging you?
Yeah.
The only way you can leave the room playing Careless Whisper on a saxophone. Lots of hip thrusting.
Okay.
And I'm just gonna grab the strap on the back and just kind of slowly pull him out.
Alright, and the last thing you see is you're just sitting there like, oh my god. As you leave. So, you guys are headed to Chinatown.
Yee.
Can he just hip thrust the whole way there?
So you quickly try to find Biscuits, and you're unable to find him. But you do run into Flowers and He's like, oh, shit. You know what? My gun, it's got some pieces that are kind of like not good inside of it, and so I'm gonna talk to the gunsmith, and we're gonna get that fixed. Before I'll catch up to you. Like, just give me like a couple hours. I'm sure I'll be with you in like a half a day.
Bring biscuits.
If I find them, yeah, no problem.
I have so much shit on my character. I need to get rid of some of this.
Like items in her backpack, or?
I've got three different weapons, and I got the mask, and I've got like a shit ton of stuff in my backpack.
Do we have to worry about encumberment rates in this, or?
Only to a certain point. Like, if you carry like some insane amounts of something, then I start paying attention to it. But
I'm carrying
as long as
gauntlets, a baseball bat, and Zandalfon. So
yeah, that's fine.
It's a fair amount of junk.
Why would you still have the baseball bat though? That sounds kind of useless.
I don't know. Just in case. You never know when a weapon gets knocked from your hands.
I don't have like an extra mace I could give her.
Why would she need?
Why are you giving me a mace? I was gonna take the holy longsword from Flowers.
Well, no, but I was gonna say if you want a blunt object, a baseball bat's shit compared to like a medieval mace. I have one of those. Is the thing.
No, it's okay. The baseball bat's actually not too bad, surprisingly. It hits as hard as my fists, as my spiked gauntlets now.
My mace does 2d6 plus 3 damage.
Yeah, baseball bat does 2d6 plus 4, apparently.
What the fuck? That doesn't make any sense.
She has more strength.
Oh.
Okay. Well, can we
trade
then? It
still has only 2d6.
Can I give her the mace and I'll take the bat? Because I want to see her with the mace. I don't like that.
Running around with the mace?
I also think your mace, isn't that a one-hander?
It doesn't say anything about that. I thought it... Oh, yeah, it would be because I have a shield. All right, that makes sense.
This is a two-hander.
All right.
I can still wield both, I think?
Can she, like, put some spikes in the bat or something? I just, like...
Just Casey Jones it?
A nail bat? Make a nail
it's
bat?
It's a metal bat. Yeah. It's a metal bat.
Shit, is it?
Yep.
I've been imagining a wooden bat this whole time.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's just gonna like splinter on some demon's horns or something.
That's why it's a metal bat, because it
I'll
would
break
splinter
it off
on a demon if it was wooden.
Then I'll improvise weapon
snap.
It into their face.
That pun. Okay, so Ren, I guess I should ask: would you all like to go to the Medica first before you leave?
Yes.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Nah, dude, we don't need health. We're just going in. All in.
I have more health than probably both of you, so...
Okay, so you all head to the Medica, and the place is an absolute mess. Lots of triage going on. You are one of hundreds in there with battle wounds of some sort. And the holy men, the healers... are running around frantically, praying over people and applying bandages, et cetera, et cetera.
Excuse me.
So are you just going to wait in line, or are you going to try to, like, get a hold of someone?
Well, Ren, if you agree with this, you and I are going to charge up to whoever's in charge and say, if you understand the concept of triage, you would prioritize the people that are about to go back out to battle. I want to intimidate this dude into helping us first. Because, like, we're going right back out to fight. As long as nobody's actually bleeding out.
I'm assuming that a lot of the people, though, are actually bleeding out. Which is more important than people trying to... That I'm fairly healthy, to be honest. I only need, like, 10 more hit points and then I'm full, but...
Well, that's selfish. Zach and I are fucked up.
I need 8.
I ran around trying to fight shit and they all ran away from me. What can I tell you?
We're not all as scary as you are.
Why don't we just spend another day, like, in the station or so until we're healed up? Is that a thing that we can do?
Or you can just... Roland, would you like to run up to someone and ask for assistance?
Or that too.
How many hours has it been since the battle? At least, like, 6 or 7, right? Because I was looking at that catalog for 2 hours.
A lot. You're looking at... it's nighttime at this point. It was like midday, so you've been probably 8 to 10 hours, because you guys also don't remember, but you guys assisted Abigail in getting and burying bodies.
Yeah. Okay. So everybody that was bleeding out has been taken care of.
No. There are still people that need extreme assistance, but no one's like extreme care. I am literally bleeding all over the floor. Save me now. Those would be.
I'm gonna do what I said. I'm gonna go up and I'm gonna demand that we get quick treatment because we're going right back out. Why would we bother spending a night here if we can get bandaged up and head out immediately?